Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In this video we are going to learn about some basic topics related to bipolar junction transistor, that is BJT. So before that, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos here. So let us see what is BJT. BJT stands for bipolar junction transistor. It is a solid state semiconductor device with three terminals, that is emitter, base and collector. It is called as bipolar junction transistor because the current conduction in this type of transistor is due to two types of charge carriers, that is electrons and holes. The bipolar junction transistor was developed by Dr. Shockley in 1951. It is widely used device in modern electronic circuits such as digital computers, satellites, mobile phones, control systems, communication systems, etc. As I told that it is a three terminal device whose output current or voltage or power is controlled by input current. Since output parameter is controlled by input current, it is called as current control device. It is made up of silicon or germanium material. Its features are: it has compact size, rugged construction, more resistive to shocks and vibrations, instantaneous operation, high efficiency, low operating voltage and long life. Next one is BJT construction. BJT, as you can see in this diagram, this is a schematic diagram of BJT or bipolar junction transistor. It has three regions: emitter region, base region and collector region. Based on the connection of the n-type and p-type material, it is divided into two types of transistors. One is npn transistor and second one is pnp transistor. Npn transistor is formed when one p-type material is sandwiched between two n-type materials, and PNP transistor is formed when one N-type material is sandwiched between two P-type materials. As you can see in this diagram, this transistor has two junctions. The junction between emitter and base region is called as emitter base junction, and the junction between base region and collector region is called as collector base junction. Both NPN and PNP transistors has two junctions. As I told that it has three region: emitter region, base region and collector region. So let us discuss about these regions briefly. First one is emitter region. Emitter region, as shown in the diagram, it is a left region of the transistor, and its function is to supply majority charge carriers to the base region. Electrons are majority charge carrier in case of NPN transistor, and holes are majority charge carriers in case of PNP transistor. And majority charge carriers are always supplied towards base. Emitter region is forward biased with respect to base. Why it is forward biased? To supply majority charge carriers to base region. Emitter region is heavily doped. Why it is heavily doped? So that it can inject majority charge carriers, large number of majority charge carriers into base region. Next one is base region. As you can see in the diagram, base region is between emitter region and collector region, and it is very lightly doped and very thin, of the order of micrometer. It is thinner than emitter and collector region. Why it is very lightly doped? So that whenever the charge carriers come from emitter region towards base region, only small amount of charge carriers can recombine here, and rest of the charge carriers are collected by the collector. So it supplied most of the charge carriers to the collector. Therefore it is lightly doped region. Third one is collector region. It is the right region of the transistor, and it's moderately doped. Moderately doped means the doping is between emitter region and base region. The collector's main function is to collect majority charge carriers coming from the emitter region through base region. Collector is always reversed bias to remove charge carriers away from the junction. Let us see the BJT symbols. As we have studied that there are two transistors. One is NPN and second one is PNP transistor. How we recognize the transistor is NPN or PNP? If it is a PNP transistor, then the arrowhead in the emitter region is towards the base region. Means the arrowhead is inwards always. If it is a NPN transistor, the arrowhead in the emitter region is always from base region to towards emitter region. Means the arrowhead is always outwards. This is the equivalent diagram in terms of PN junctions for the PNP and NPN transistor. If it is a PNP transistor, then the diode equivalent is two diodes connected in this fashion. And if it is a NPN transistor, the diode equivalent is two diodes connected in this fashion. Two PN junction diodes are connected here. Next one is terminal identification. It is the two types of packaging of the transistor. If we want to recognize the terminals, then in this type of packaging, the emitter is towards left side, base is in middle and collector toward right side. If it is the packaging is like this, then base is in left side, emitter is right side and collector is back side. Next one is transistor biasing. Transistor biasing, biasing of transistor means whenever we apply a voltage to the transistor, then the process of applying voltage is called as biasing. There are mainly three types of biasing studied in the transistor: forward-reverse biasing, forward-forward biasing and reverse-reverse biasing. First one is forward-reverse biasing. It is the normal mode of operation of the transistor. In this mode, emitter-based junction is forward-biased and collector-based junction is reverse biased. The transistor in this mode acts in the active region, and in this collector current, that is IC, depends on the input current, that is emitter current IE. This mode of operation used in the amplification process. Next one is forward-forward biasing. In this mode of operation, emitter-based junction of the transistor is forward-biased and collector-based junction of the transistor is also forward-biased. Transistor in this region operates in saturation region. Because both the junctions are forward-biased, large value of current flows in this mode. And the transistor, because large value of current flows in this mode, the transistor in this mode used as closed switch. Third one is reverse-reverse biasing. In this mode, emitter-based junction is reverse biased and collector-based junction is also reverse biased. In this biasing, because both the junctions are reverse biased, practically zero current flows. Because emitter does not emit charge carriers into the base and no charge carriers are collected by the collector. But only thermally generated charge carriers flows, due to which reverse current, reverse saturation current can flow. The transistor in this region acts in cutoff region. Thus, transistor acts as open switch due to zero value of current. Let us see these three regions in tabular form. We have three modes of operation in transistor: active mode, saturation mode and cutoff mode. In active mode, emitter-based junction is forward-biased, collector-based junction is reverse-biased. In saturation mode, emitter-based junction is forward-biased and collector-based junction is also forward-biased. And in cutoff region, emitter-based junction is reverse-biased and collector-based junction is also in reverse-biased condition. So that's all for today, the BJT basics. Thank you for watching my video.